I heard this one story about your first movie and how you got it. It's really cool. Please tell me. I heard that he was not the, you were not the first choice for that character.
No, I was nowhere on the horizon. So the funny thing, Renal, was I came back from New York.
Yeah.
I'd done my master's in film.
Yeah.
All polished and, you know, ready to come in and dazzle.
Yeah.
And my dad, as tradition was in those days, you know, star sons would be launched by their star dads.
Yeah.
So, yeah, my launch pad was being made ready with, as though I was a rocket or a missile.
Yeah.
As Abbas Mustan Saab. Their team was writing a script and there was a big film and it was very expensive. And I kept hearing these numbers, itna kharcha ho raha hai, itna hum dal rahe hain. It was all my dad's money.
Correct.
Everything that he had earned in his life. And somewhere, two things. One, I think the concern that, what if this doesn't work out? I don't want my father to lose, you know, all that he's earned and gamble it on me. And the second thing was a point of principle where I said that, look, I idolize my dad, even though he's from, you know, blue blood, he's from a royal family, because they look down upon the movie industry.
Right.
He left it behind, had the guts to take 400 borrowed rupees from his best friend and say, Mumbai, here I come. And he made it, right?
Yeah.
So I said, look, I want to be like you, dad. And my dad's whole thing was, look, I did the struggle so that you don't have to struggle. I built you a platform. And I said, you did the struggle. That's what made you successful and prepared you for anything in life.
Yeah, yeah.
I want the same for me.
Yeah.
And I actually spent a whole year and a half struggling. So it was me dropping Oberoi, just the name Vivekanand, going out there, meeting people, standing in, I think, outside offices for 10, 12 hours.
Wow.
Being told at every step, you can't be an actor, you can't be a hero. Tumme wo baat nahi hai. The one thing that we get a lot in India free is advice.
Yeah,
and most of it is useless.
Is
so yeah, got that a lot. And then one fine day, found out Ram Gopal Varma is making this film called Company.
Yeah.
Landed up somehow, used whatever I could. There was a friend of mine called Soham Shah, who's actually a director now.
Yeah, yeah.
He used to design posters then. So through him, I angled and somehow got to Ramuji. Met him and he said, look, you're great. I'm very impressed with your whole New York stint and everything. But you're not the guy I'm looking for. I said, why? Says, I want somebody rough, rugged, you know, a guy from the slums and streets. And you're this polished, you know, good-looking boy who's,
Masters,
you know, sophisticated and all of that. Yeah, exactly. So I said, give me 15 days, sir. He said yes and forgot about it. Like people check into a hotel, I checked into a slum. I actually went in and paid bhada for a kholi and lived in a kholi and slept on the floor. Was introduced with the nightlife there. The nightlife there is insane because you're mingling generally with rats that are somehow this size. I don't know how they look bigger than cats there. If you had to have a bath, there was
my
no...
My OCD is already kicking there was inside
a, now. No running shower. You have to have a bath, get your plastic magga, go into this rusting drum and pull out, tie a towel and bathe in the open. Because that's how it used to be back then. Food... Everything was still manageable. What was most difficult, Renner, was when you needed to go to the loo. And when you had to stand in a line outside the Sulabh Sauchale, you realized the value of 1 rupee. Because without that 1 rupee, you can't go inside. So yeah, I went through that experience for about 15 days, prepped myself, took pictures.
Yeah.
In that space, in that life, right, in that zone. Like a day in the life of Chandu Nagre. And brought it back to RGV. I'd taken an appointment. My whole attempt was, look, I've got this one chance, can't blow it.
Yeah.
So I dressed up like the character. I was in chappals, stone ganji, dirty shirt, rugged hair, you know, all of that, and a bunch of photographs in one hand and a beady in the mouth. And I reached his office and...
And you showed him, this is
the guard stopped me first. The guard stopped me and I was elated. I was like, yes! You know, pehla padav. Cross the first step, convince the guard. And then RGV says, send him up. And I remember there was a moment, there was a crazy moment where I looked at my face in the reflection in the, you know, one-way glass, in the tinted glass. I saw my face and I said, I'm looking really squeaky clean, man. And then I looked down and the guard was staring at me. He couldn't believe what he saw. I dug my hands into the flower pot outside. Took matti out of the flower pot and started putting it on my face. The guard was just staring at me like, who is this psycho?
I would imagine. I would imagine that happening.
Walked into the office, said a prayer, kicked the door open, swaggered in, pulled up a chair, sat on it, put my feet up on his table, stared at him, death stare, eye to eye. And he's just looking at me, fascinated. I'm staring at him, puffing on my beedi and just staring and say, hey, topda kya dekhta hai, photo dekh, photo. And I throw a whole bunch of photographs on his table. And he started looking at these pictures and he says, that's the craziest but best audition I've ever seen and you're doing my film. And I was like, are you sure? And he's like, why are you asking me that? I said, because I want to say something. She says, what? I'm Suresh Ji's son. Why didn't you tell me before? I was like, you know, I wanted to do this all merit.
That's crazy.
The day he told my dad that your son's doing my film, I mean, I've been blessed with a lot of awards in my life, Renal. But when I saw those tears of pride in my father's eyes, to me, they're still the greatest award I've ever won.
Yeah, no, makes sense.
It was a sense of you did it, man. Yeah. You know, you did it on your own.